quarter to three. There's no one in the place except you and me. Set 'em up, Joe. I got a little story you ought to know. We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. I got the routine, drop another nickel in the machine. I'm feeling so bad, wish you'd make the music dreamy and sad.
Hi, I'm Bob Clark, and I'm the executive director of Cinekit Enterprises Incorporated. And I'd like to tell you about a new series that we're offering as part of this year's Cinekit Television Theater. It's called Dear Mr. Disney, and it's set in a time period that's probably very unfamiliar to many of the boys and girls who are part of Cinekit, and may even be strange for some of our younger viewers. It's set in the early 1950s, in that period right before the advent of Elvis Presley and rock and roll. Essentially, it deals with the members of a little suburban community, one of those things that developed right after World War II, about 20 miles north of the city of Philadelphia. And some of the characters whom you'll be meeting in this story, Dear Mr. Disney, are the Davis family. Mrs. Clarissa Davis, who originally was from the Deep South, her four children, Jefferson Davis, who prefers to be called Jeff, her youngest son, Robert E. Davis, nicknamed Bo, her two daughters, Melanie and Sue Ellen. Now, the Davis youngsters have some friends in the neighborhood. They're interesting. A brother and sister, the Nelsons, live next door. The girl's name is Mary, and her brother's name is Michael. And for reasons that were appropriate to that time, his nickname is Sea Hunt. In addition to that, they have a friend named Bobby Smith, whose nickname is Howdy. And he's always glued to the television set, and his favorite show is, of course, Howdy Doody. The fourth one of their friends and neighbors is a young person named Randolph Arthur Llewellyn III. His nickname is Randy, and his folks, although residents of this community, have greater ideas about their wealth and prominence. They're all a pretty interesting group of characters. Well, the story goes beyond what happened in this little community in the early 50s. It also takes us to the West Coast, and it involves a very, very famous Hollywood agent. Her name is Marty Jacobs, and one of her clients, a former child star named Little Jackie Jones, who has reached his early teens and is finding it very difficult to continue his once promising career. Moreover, a family has just moved from the West Coast, from the Los Angeles area, around where the Davises live. And these are the Gumbergs. Mr. Gregory Gumberg, the father, his wife, the former beautician, Verna Gumberg, and their son Gary, a pretty nice kid who's trying desperately to fit into things around the Davis' neighborhood. Well, the story is based upon a real-life incident that once the Walt Disney television show had achieved great fame and prominence, Mr. Disney, or Uncle Walt as he preferred to be called, decided that he was going to initiate a brand new TV show just for kids, called, of course, the Mickey Mouse Club, and that the boys and girls who were part of that would be known forevermore as the Mouseketeers. And some of the Davis children and their friends and that former Hollywood star, Little Jackie Jones, want desperately to become a part of that series. And so, back in 1953, 1954, these players become part of our little drama, which we call Dear Mr. Disney.
For my baby and one more for the road. You'd never know it, but buddy, I'm a kind of poet. I got a lot of things to say.
Mm-hmm. frozen. What? Oh, no.
Thank you.
What kind of deal?
I'll make sure you win that first prize. You take me a prize.
See, first of all, I don't think you could do that. Second of all, you're a man to blame, alright? Now, why can't you just... and be in Hawaii? I mean, why do you need a ticket to go to Hawaii?
Well, I can just... and I'm in Hawaii. But I just thought it would be fun to fly first class.
Well, see... I don't think so. I mean, I'd rather take my chances like everyone else. And besides, it wouldn't be fair.
Okay, suit yourself, an honest lad.
Banko for What's New at the Movies. There's a lot of good films coming out this fall, and I'm going to be previewing them for you. This week, we will be taking a look at two of the fall's latest releases. The first, entitled Jumping Jack Flash, stars Whoopi Goldberg in her film comedy debut. Let's take a look.
Meet Terry Doolittle.
Yeah! Hi!
She was on her way up.
I have the promotion.
Philip.
Oh, God, I haven't.
Until she fell in with the wrong crowd.
Mr. Van Meter? Mr. Van Meter?
What do you mean he's dead?
Dead?
Now, she's trying to stay alive.
Some guy calling himself Jumping Jack Flash taps into my computer.
And save a guy named Jumping Jack Flash.
What? Jumping Jack Flash.
The KGB? The KGB?
Whoa! I'm a little black woman in a big silver box. On the top of the thing says phone.
Is she on some kind of medication?
Oh, 20th Century Fox presents Whoopi Goldberg in her first motion picture comedy.
And that's the truth.
Jumping Jack Flash. Jumping Jack Flash.
Oh, get it. Jumping
Jack. Our second film, Streets of Gold, is a contemporary drama starring Claus Marais Brandauer. The film opens November 14th. Let's take a brief look.
I was boxer in Russia. I was champion.
I have two boys I have been coaching.
Well, you gonna give me a fight with the champ?
Look, I never had any real training. I mean, everything I do is on instinct.
Give them a chance to fight in open trials.
Streets of Gold is a contemporary drama about a former Soviet boxing champion who regains his purpose and self-respect in America after he befriends and coaches two young fighters.
If you're looking for a fighter, you're wasting your time. No matter how much you teach him, he's nothing. You know it just like I do. I'm the best fighter.
Academy Award nominee Claus Maria Brandauer stars in this exciting film from first-time director Joe Roth and filmed on New York City locations.
You want to win? Let these boys fight.
You come over here, and I'll spit you to death.
Co-starring Adrian Pascal and Wesley Snipes, Streets of Gold opens November 14th.
That's it for this week's edition of What's New at the Movies. I hope you enjoyed our show. Join us in the weeks to come when we will be previewing more of the latest releases.
It's Disney night, so come on down with your family, bring the kids. It's sure to be a great time, right, kids? Right. Kids, can you keep it down? Quiet! Thank you. Excuse me. Well, as usual, tickets are $2. The doors open at 7 and the show starts at 7:30. So bring everybody on down. You're sure to have fun with Disney at CineKid.
We're rolling.
Oh my gosh. Hi.
I'm not
like
doing
a
anything.
Frog.
Beck, we're getting this done now.
Are you looking like a frog one? You're fun. You're making me laugh. It's all your fault. You realize that.
And you said
wait, Eric, can you like hide yourself behind the camera? Because you're making me laugh. Here, wait. Put a piece of paper over your face. All right, I'm ready. Hello, I'm Wendy Waldman from Behind the Scenes, and today we'll be looking at acting the CineKid way. I can't do this.
Yeah, let's not be silly.
Well, we certainly... Wait a minute. Well, we certainly hope...
Hi, I'm getting interviewed. Oh, God. Here he comes.
Hello, I'm Wendy Waldman, and I'm Becky Clark. And today we'll be showing you acting the CineKid way. And we'll show you what CineKid's young actors and actresses have to say about their experiences through CineKid.
That's good, Becky. You're good at both lines.
Hi, I'm Becky Clark, and this is Aaron Bird.
Most of the interviews you see from CineKid are from mostly,
Hello, I'm Wendy Waldman from Behind the Scenes. Today we'll be looking at how CineKid's actors and actresses developed their...
So funny. You wanted to laugh in the very beginning. I could tell.
You write me a cue card.
I'm going to write a cue card.
No.
Wait, I can't do it with him. I'm sorry. All right, I'm ready. Get away.
There are many words to describe CineKid.
Such as magic.
I went through here. I'm sorry, my lips aren't working.
Hello, I'm Wendy Waldman. I can't even do the first line now.
Hi, I'm Wendy Waldman for Behind the Scenes. Tonight, I'm just going to give you a brief background on what the actors and actresses have to go through to prepare for their summer performance in the summer feature. And this year, we're going to be taking a look at how they do in The Ancestors.
Hi, you two.
Hi, now you can stop rolling the deck.
Bye.
I know.
Hello, I'm Wendy Waldman from Behind the Scenes.